So the customer is saying that the dryer is heating, but it's not turning, so it's not drying the clothes correctly. And we're gonna find out what's going on. Welcome to DIY Repair Now. Read all the warnings. And during this video, you will see one or more of these icons to help you do this repair safe. Today, we're gonna be working on a KitchenAid dryer. The model number is on the display. And the customer said that the dryer is not drying the clothes correctly. And when he opens the door, it looks like it's not turning. So we're gonna find out why the drum is not turning or spinning the clothes to be able to dry it correctly. We're gonna go ahead and pull this up with our flathead screwdriver. And as you can see, the dry belt is not in place. So we're gonna go ahead and turn it off. As you can see, we're trying to put it on certain settings and it's heating, but it's not turning because it's no belt. You can see inside, we can feel some heat, but it's not turning. Go ahead and disconnect the appliance to avoid electric shock. We're gonna go ahead and pull this forward and try to get some space to be able to take it apart. Now we're gonna go ahead and remove the two 5/16 screws that are holding the front panel, like so. It's one on each side. And again, there are 5/16 screws. You can use a 5/16 screwdriver or 5/16 bit on your drill. Now we're gonna disconnect the harness for the door switch and just put like a flathead screwdriver. Be careful, don't slip the screwdriver while you doing this because you can get hurt really easy. Just try to open it and just follow the video the way I'm doing to avoid, you know, cutting yourself or anything like that until it gets loose. Now we're gonna remove the front panel and I'm gonna show you guys right here. It's a hook there and it's a hole on the other side and that's how it's assembled. As you can see, once you lift it up, it will come right out as you see on this footage. So just lift it up and it will release it from the hook the same way you would put it back on. Here is the belt just laying on the floor and the drum is all loose because there's no belt in place. Now we're gonna go ahead and remove this. Make sure to take pictures of everything that you do before you take anything apart to remember where everything was. Just go on your phone and take a look at it and then that will help you to determine. That little piece of plastic supposed to be on the motor shaft, but it's on the floor. That would not affect this repair. They don't sell that little piece of plastic, so we're just gonna go ahead and put it to the side. We're not gonna mess with that. Now, this is the way you remove and this is the way you reinstall your dry belt in case you're using this video too, taking it apart. This is the new belt that I'm installing in place. Remember, be careful with sharp edges and just follow the video and this will help you to get it done in your own. As you see, the dry belt is in place. And now we're gonna go ahead and just start putting everything back together. Remember about the hooks on the bottom of the front panel, the front cabinet of the dryer. Go ahead and try to spin it with your hand. Make sure the dry belt is in place the way it's supposed to and it's not slipping or it's not a flip like the other way around. Once you make sure everything is right, just go ahead and start putting your front panel back in place. Remember about the hooks and the male to female connection on the bottom. It's a hook that goes in a hole. Yes, if you wanna go back on the video, just go back on the video, remember how this was. Remember you have to go ahead and keep the drum up to be able to put it in that part of the front panel. sometimes it's a little tricky, depends on the space that you're working on, but you get the idea. That one I couldn't get a footage, but in this one, as you see, we have the male to female connection there. The hook, once it's in place, you just push it down and it will fit right in his housing. Now we're gonna go ahead and start putting everything back together. We're gonna go ahead and install our two 5/16 screws that holds the front panel in place on the top area. Sometimes these little pieces will go off track, so make sure you put them the way it's supposed to. At this point, we're pretty much done. We're gonna go ahead and plug our harness for the door, for the front door of the dryer. Now we're gonna go ahead and plug the dryer to make sure that dry belt is gonna stay in place. At this point, we can hear the dryer spinning. So we're gonna go ahead and just show you guys how it's spinning. And that's the way it should be. Now we're gonna go ahead and turn it off and finish putting this last two Phillips screws in place. Now you have to be careful with these screws because sometimes they will fail and they will go inside to that vent right there. So try to do it by hand or with a magnet screwdriver to avoid those screws going inside the vent. If they do, it might not be a big deal. Just use for another Phillips screws, but you try to avoid that. And this time, after I put it with my hands, I just use my drill to tighten them up, put the drive, the dryer in place. And at this point, we're pretty much done. We're gonna go ahead and clean our filter. Look at this filter. This is one of the reasons why maybe that dry belt could overheat and got, you know, toasted and all dry and then broke. But you know, you guys supposed to clean this filter pretty much in every load. At this point, you know, I got the dryer on and it's working fine. We just gotta clean this filter and that'll be it for this video.